Good morning, everybody. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Ridler Studios. I am Jamie, and it is Tuesday. So if you're Canadian, I hope you had a lovely Thanksgiving. I certainly did. It was nice to have a long weekend. It was a balance of rest and activity and a wonderful Thanksgiving dinner with family. Thank you, Sylvia, for that. So I've been thinking a little bit about listening. I've actually been thinking a lot about listening. And this morning I was thinking about how it actually, in our creative lives, listening has the same triangle as honor the work. So remember last week we talked about honor the work and that meant honoring ourselves, honoring the work, and honoring the other. And I was thinking about how listening is the same. That we want to make sure that we are listening to ourselves, that we are listening to the work, and that we are listening to other people too. And that made me realize, whenever I see that three-point triangle showing up, it makes me think about practice projects and performance, which some of you will have taken my Creative Forum series on practice projects and performance. It was available last summer. And we dove into these three powerful aspects of creativity. And I was thinking about that in terms of listening. So when we listen to ourselves, this is something that practice is really good for. So journaling on a regular basis, we get to hear our own voice, see our own words, experience our own ideas, our own history, our thoughts pouring out onto the page. So developing a practice so that we can truly hear ourselves and be grounded in our own thoughts and in our own vision, in our own experience, is essential to living a creative life. And then projects, that's when something starts to come to life. And that's when we start listening to, see, this is what some people do, is they listen to others. But from my perspective, this is not the time to listen to others. It's the time to start with listening what's coming out of you and starting to notice what has a little bit of substance, what has a little bit of pull, what has a little bit of energy, what feels like a thing. That ends up being what I always say. That feels like a thing, like something that wants to come to life. It wants to be a class. It wants to be a painting. It wants to be a series. It wants to be a show. It wants to be a podcast. It wants to be a blog post. It wants to be a thing. Now, one of the things we always discover in planning day, if you've done it with me before, is we get a lot more ideas of something that wants to be a thing than we're able to take on. It's just the nature of it. If it's like if I planted every seed in this little patch of yard, it would end up an overgrown tumble of things struggling to survive because there's only limited resources. And so instead, if I choose this and this and this and this, suddenly they have room to grow strong, to have enough sunshine, to have enough space, enough soil, enough water, and they can grow vigorous and strong. When we start to feel that idea and we start to choose, and then we start bringing something to life, our listening to the project continues. What does it want to be? Where does it want to go? What does it need next? And then there is a space. If this is a project that you know you want to share with others, then you start also having that performance ear. You start listening for the other. You start listening for your audience. You start thinking not just this is what I want to express, but how would this help? How do I need to express this in a way that somebody else can understand it? Are these instructions that I've written for this crochet blanket, are they clear? Could somebody else read them and replicate what I've done? And that becomes a part, you know, almost then you're starting to move into editing and starting to moving into the listening to others. And when you are sharing your work with others, I call that performance. So we have practice, projects, performance. We have honor ourselves, honor the work, honor one another. We have listen to ourselves, listen to the work, and listen to one another too. The right time for the right task will make all the difference to what we're creating and how we are experiencing the creative process. So for example, let's talk about going to a yoga class. Maybe especially going when we're new to yoga. How do we honor ourselves? We pay attention to our own bodies. We pay attention to our own needs. When we are on our own mat, we are on our own mat. We are paying attention to our own bodies. We are not paying attention to the person beside us and what their downward dog looks like, or the person over there and what their tights look like. We are not paying attention to that. We are honoring ourselves. And when we pay attention to ourselves and our relationship with the work on the mat, we are honoring the work. When we are showing up and doing the best we can in this moment, we are honoring the work. And when do we honor one another? We honor one another by listening to the instructor. We honor his or her words. We honor one another by being polite and conscious of space or our impact on the people beside us. We are not a distraction. We are a support. And so I invite you to take something in your life. It doesn't have to be a creative something. It could be a project you have at work. It could be driving your kids to school, cleaning your bedroom, anything. And ask yourself, how can I honor myself, the work, and others? And how can I listen to myself, the work, and others? And I'm exploring the thought here, explore it with me, of is there a bit of a hierarchy here? I believe there is. So listening to others should never, in our artwork, in our creativity, in what we want to create in the world, including our lives, listening to others does not override either the voice of the work itself, the life that wants to be expressed through you, the work that wants to come out through you, nor yourself. And then the work should not override ourselves. So no matter how much we love being a dancer or being a poet or wanting to put a show on August 1st or whatever, we should not hurt ourselves, betray ourselves, be untrue to ourselves in order to make that happen. That the strongest work, by the way, people do this all the time. I've done this all the time. I have exhausted myself in order to put a show on. I have listened to others more strongly than myself. There are times when we do put others first. I'm not suggesting that that's not appropriate. That is often called philanthropy. But the strongest work with the most sustainable energy that's going to come through you is when you are as strong as you can be, as resilient as you can be, where you are true and you are in integrity. So you don't have all these cricks in your energy from trying to bend this way and that. You are open and free and strong and real, and your right work can pour through you. And then on top of that, that right work will be strongest when you are able to hold it, nourish it, support it, when you are not breaking in order to serve it, but can serve it like the two of you are in strong relationship, loving one another and holding one another up. And yes, that'll mean sometimes the work energizes you and lifts up your adrenaline, so that you're able to accomplish it before you move into the stage of rest. And that can be exciting and wonderful and acute, not long-term, a moment. And then when those things are strong, that that relationship between you and the work is strong, then when you offer it up out into the world for others, when it is deep and true and real, there will be resonance, there will be magic, there will be something that connects between your deepest truth connected to the work's deepest truth that will connect to somebody else's deepest truth. So practice projects performance. And you may know right now that there's one area that needs some attention that's calling. Practice is something that can always be a part of your life. It is the ground. So strengthen that or start that. And then moving into projects and then moving into sharing. So all of that came together while I was thinking about listening. And I think about listening every time I come to do the BTS, because the BTS comes out of either my listening to my heart. There's something going on with me. There's something stirring. There's something I'm noticing. And I know that if there's something real for me, that it will have resonance with others. So I start there. Or I'm working on something and some idea flows in and it's really present and alive and I share that. Or I'm in a class, I'm leading journal club, I'm listening to what's in the zeitgeist of the creative world and I start to feel like, yeah, this needs something, needs to be put in the spotlight. This needs to be raised up and talked about. And one of those things is listening. If we were having this conversation over coffee on a Tuesday morning, I'd be able to say to you, so what's up? So what's up with you? What's on your mind? What are you thinking about? What's going on in your life? So I want to say that to you right now, and I hope that you will share with me in the comments and what's stirring up for you, what ideas are on your periphery that you want to bring into the spotlight. What's your reaction to projects, practice, performance, honoring the work on these three levels, listening on these three levels? Where would you place your attention this week in practice, projects, or performance, in honoring yourself, the work, or one another, in listening to yourself, the work, or one another? Where would you plant your focus to do the most powerful and meaningful work in your studio? Which, remember, your life is your studio. Where would you do that this week? Let me know what you're thinking, and remember to send me a cat to join our cat community on the board. I love that we have this seasonal project of creating art together. I really look forward to your creations. Remember to sign your work, and I will give you the post office box at the end of the show. Thanks so much for hanging out with me this morning. It's always a joy to hang out with you. I will